Hi, my name is Matt Bernhardt, and this is a Massive Report screencast.
So today I'd like to talk about something I've been calling a line chart, which is a way of visualizing the playing time for a single player. If you remember in previous, last screencast, we talked about this waterfall chart or a lineup progression chart, which allows you to see the history of a team in kind of one fell swoop, where you have every player the team that's ever played, and you have every game the team has ever played, and you can see in the intersection which players appeared in which games, who started, who came on as a sub, and who scored a goal. And that's really great for those kind of large scale histories, or you know, the larger dynamics of how rosters change over time when they're very stable versus when there's a lot of turnover. But for the kind of to get any deeper, you kind of have to change visualization strategies. And to illustrate that point, I'm going to start looking at two players from last season, Emilio Renteria and Tommy Heinemann. Renteria and Heinemann both played about the same amount of minutes last year. Renteria played in about 37% of the season. Heinemann played in about 39% of the season. And if you look really closely, you can see, you know, Heinemann obviously only scored 3 goals. Renteria scored 8. You know, any look at any stats chart will tell you that much. But then if you look at in the waterfall, you see, you know, a lot more numbers under Heinemann, indicating he played in a lot more games, but he didn't play very long in any given game, whereas Renteria got his playing time in more concentrated chunks. That is somewhat apparent here, but it becomes really apparent in these kind of line charts, where you repeat the kind of motif where every game the team plays is a single row on the chart, but now instead of, you know, your participation being reduced to a number, it's laid out horizontally. So, you know, in this case, you have Renteria. He starts the first game, the home game against Real Salt Lake in the quarterfinals. He gets tossed in about the 76th minute or something, and he has to sit the next game. He doesn't make it onto the field again until April 1st, and you can see he got a good number of starts in. He played a good number of minutes. He got 4 goals, and then he got injured, so we missed a whole bunch of time, and then he came back, got another 2 goals, missed another couple games, and then finished the season fairly strongly, got another 2 goals. Compare that with Tommy Heinemann, who, you know, played somewhat consistently but never a long time. It actually took him until July 23rd to get a full complete game in where he wasn't pulled at some, you know, at least in the 89th minute or somewhere late, or didn't get on the field until late in the game anyway. Those patterns come out more in a line chart where you can kind of visually lay out, you know, which minutes a player was on the field, and you get it in a graphic way that's, I think, a little bit more easily understood. Now, the next step of this whole process is something that really starts to become possible with this kind of visualization, as well as through the next thing that we're going to explore a little bit later in the next screencast, which is if you look at Heinemann and Renteria and you flip back and forth there, or if you overlay them on top of each other, you start to realize that very rarely did Heinemann and Renteria actually stand on the field together. In this visualization, you've got the blue bars are Renteria's playing time and the yellow bars are Tommy Heinemann's time, and these kind of burnt orange bars are the times that those two players were on the field together. So here's, you know, a handful of minutes on April 23rd. You've got another, you know, handful of minutes here. First 40, 45 minutes on May 21st. And then you've got a couple other periods throughout the season where they were on the field together, but it really wasn't very long at all. And I think that's pretty interesting to think about, to see, you know, this begins to set up the ability to do comparisons where did the team play better with Heinemann on the field or with Renteria on the field? And I think when we get into the numbers, it'll become interestingly clear that the team actually scored goals at about the same rate with Heinemann versus Renteria. The difference is when Heinemann was on the field, he wasn't doing the scoring. Other players were, but the team was still scoring goals. Whereas with Renteria was on the the field, he was scoring a lot of goals. And it, you know, we can then look at, you know, who else was scoring goals with Renteria on the field. This kind of, you know, never one, never both players, only one or the other, begins to become apparent in this kind of a visualization where you lay out, in this case, for Tommy Heinemann, you know, how many minutes he played in the season, how many minutes he didn't play in the season, and in those minutes, who else was on the field. So you see, you know, Sebastian Miranda was always on the field versus a player like Emilio Renteria, who, you know, there was a lot of times where Renteria was on the field and very few times were they on the field together. Jeff Cunningham, similarly, Kevin Burns, interestingly, and Dilly Duca, not very much overlap versus a player like Bernardo Anor, who, you know, whenever Anor was on the field, almost always was Heinemann on the field, and very rarely was Anor on the field himself. Same thing with Andy Grunebaum, and, you know, you can flip over to Emilio Renteria, and this is the image where it really becomes clear, at least in my mind, that Renteria and Heinemann just didn't play together, because for all of Renteria's minutes, you see, you know, the kind of usual suspects who are always there. Yeah, they were always there on the field, and then Tommy Heinemann just shoots up off the, you know, way up into the area where Renteria didn't play. And then Bernardo Anor, you know, interestingly, also very rarely played. It was, you know, almost only maybe 10-15 minutes was Anor on the field with Renteria at the same time. So these are the kind of line charts that I wanted to cover today, and I hope you find them interesting in terms of graphically laying out the playing time that a player got. As always, I invite your comments down below in the comments area, and I look forward to talking to you next time. Thank you very much.